So good morning, my dear students. Today we are going to do chapter in the Kingdom of Fools. This chapter is from your supplementary reader book, and this chapter is written by A.K. Ramanujan. So in this chapter, basically one story is being described in a very nice way. The story about a king, okay, and his minister. See, they are having one kingdom, but this king, in this kingdom, king and his ministers all are brainless. They are good for nothing. Okay. So see, if such kind of kingdom is there, because kings are always known to be very intelligent person, very wise person. They take very firm decisions. They take big, big decision because whole of the kingdom is under their supervision. But in this kingdom, the king and his minister all are brainless person. They don't have mind at all. So that's why this caption is given to the chapter, In the Kingdom of Fools. So what will happen in the Kingdom of Fools? Tell me, when king is having no brain, when his ministers are brainless, what will happen? Tell me. Okay, what do you think? Okay, Renuka is saying that they will not be able to take good decisions. They'll be taking wrong decisions. Okay, Divya. Yes, conflict will arise, she is saying. So this is all, there is a lot of suspense in the chapter that basically what happens in the Kingdom of Fools. So begin this chapter, to understand this chapter, first of all, you understand the main characters of this story, that what are the main characters of this story. So the main first character is king. Main first character is king. And king is considered foolish king. Foolish king who has executed himself. Okay, so this is the main character of the chapter, king. Next character we have minister. See, in this Kingdom of Fools, after king, we have next character, that is minister. And minister is always known that minister always gives advice to kings. But here, which kind of minister is that who always give foolish advice? Foolish advice. Okay, so this is basically a foolish advisor. Okay. And he always agrees with the king. With his foolish decisions. See, you might have seen in kingdoms what happens. Whenever any of the decision is taken, when king takes any of the decision, he always discusses about all the things with minister, that this decision has been taken, this decision is right or wrong. Okay, so minister discusses this thing, yes, we should take. But in this chapter, the minister, he always agrees with the foolish decisions of king. It means whatever the foolish decisions are taken by king, minister says, okay, agrees. He always nods his head like this in the form of a yes. Okay, so there are two main characters. The first is king. Second, we have minister. Next character we have is guru. Okay. Guru is, you can say, a resourceful person. Why it is beeping like that? A very resourceful person, and this person has magical powers. Okay. This guru, he is a resourceful person who has magical power. Who has magical powers and he becomes kings. He becomes king. There is a suspense in the chapter at last. What happens? That he gets a chance to become a king. Okay. Okay, after that we have this file. It means it is a greedy and very short-sighted person. That person is considered a greedy, and you can say short-sighted. Short-sighted means who is not thinking about future, who always thinks about now what will happen. He always thinks about his mean, about his purpose. Okay, so that is short-sighted. So first of all, try to understand the traits of these four characters. Try to understand the traits of these four characters: Guru, King, and Minister. Okay. So then you will be able to understand the whole text. So for that, I'm going to share screen with you. Let's read this interesting chapter. In the kingdom of fools. It means student, pupil. Pupil, student. You want to read now? Now listen, bachche, stop your conversation. Shall we start with the chapter? Okay. Now Simran, you read only first paragraph. Only first paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. In the kingdom of fools, both the king and the minister were idiots. They didn't want to run things like other kings. So they decided to change night into day and day into night. They ordered that everyone should be awake at night till their fields and run their businesses only after dark and go to bed as soon as the sun came up. Anyone who disobeyed would be punished with death. The people did as they were told for the fear of death. The king and the minister were delighted at the success of their project. One day, a guru and his disciple arrived in the city. It was a beautiful city. It was broad daylight, but there was no one about. Everyone was asleep, not a mouse stirring. Even the cattle had been taught to sleep by day. The two strangers were amazed by what they saw around them and wandered around town till evening, when suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nightly business. Ma'am, you're not audible.
Basically, why it is known as a kingdom of fools? Now I'm audible? Now yes, am ma'am. I audible? Okay. Basically, what happens in the kingdom of fools? King also and minister. Both were idiots. Both were brainless, having no mind. Why so? Because they have brought a very tremendous change. What decision they have taken, that they gave instruction to the public in their kingdom that all the public, they should consider night as day and day as night. Okay. And this instruction was also given that if any of the public, they would not follow these instructions, they would be severely punished. Okay. So they ordered everyone that for the whole night, they should be awakened. They should work in their fields. They should run their business. Whatever they work, they do during day. During night, they should do such kind of works. And as soon as there is a, you can say sunrise, they should go to their bed. It means they should sleep early in the morning. So anyone who would not obey this, that person would be given punishment as a death. Clear? So now the people, they were not having any choice. What they have to do? They have to follow their foolish king. Only king and minister. So people, they have to follow their king. And at this, when they made this decision, at this king and minister, they both were so delighted. What is the meaning of delighted? Happy. They were so happy that their project is getting so smoothly, that whatever the decision they have taken, it is running so smoothly in the public. Common people were following with lots of, you can say, fright, with lots of fear, because they were completely afraid. So basically it was a, because they were a fool. See, whatever the things we can do during day, during sunlight, can we do all these things during night? It will be difficult for us. If your school goes on in night and during day you are supposed to sleep, would it be okay? I love the feel. During night, if you go here and there, it will be safe for you. So basically, it was a very beautiful city. Okay, there was a broad daylight, but during daylight, no one was seen on the road. Okay, everybody was asleep. Everybody was sleeping. Okay, even a mouse, it was not stirring. It was not moving during day. It means such kind of panic was created by king and minister. Okay, even the cattle, they were also, cattle means animals. Even the animals were also given such kind of instruction that they should sleep during day, and they should, because he was fool. So there is a suspense, you will definitely come to know. Be inquisitive throughout the whole chapter. So there were two strangers. They were so amazed. Amazed means they were so surprised, stunned, wondered that why this is happening. So whatever they saw around them, and they were wandering. Wandering means they were roaming here and there till evening. So they were so surprised, and suddenly the whole town woke up and went about its nighty business. So when it was a time of sunset, people start awakening and they went on their work. Students, 9th A, listen. Third period is also of English. Online students, so log in accordingly. After this break, third period is also in English. Am I clear? I don't know, raise your hand. I don't know, arrangement is given to me. You have to log in third period in English class. Let me teach. It is not my fault. Okay. Now, Dhiren, you read next paragraph.
Yes, ma'am. May I start?
Yes.
The two men were hungry. Now that the shops were open, they went to buy some groceries. To their astonishment, they found that everything cost the same, a single doo-doo. Whenever they bought a measure of rice or bunch of bananas, it cost a doo-doo. The guru and his disciple was delighted. They had never heard of anything like this. They could buy all the food they wanted for a rupee.
Now see, when such kind of activities were going on, that during day there was a pin drop silence. So So as soon as the night started falling, so there was a hustle and bustle in the town. So two strangers, they were so hungry, and now the shops were open. So they went in those shops to purchase some of the grocery. But to their astonishment means surprise, wonder, amazement, they found that everything was costing the same. A single judu, whether they bought a measure of rice, whether they purchased a bunch of bananas, everything was having a same price. Judu here is a unit of money. Write down in your books. It means whatever was purchased in the market, everything was having a same price. So judu means a unit of price. It means whether they were purchasing rice, whether they were purchasing bananas, everything was having same price. So the guru and his disciple, they all were so happy, and they had never got a chance to hear such kind of thing. Okay, so both stranger, guru and his pupil, both, they thought that it is a very good opportunity. So they should purchase all the food having a price of 1 rupee. Okay. So Dhiren, read further also. Dhiren, start reading. Dhiren has gone to have his breakfast.
Ma'am, I was mute.
So tell me, please, father.
Okay, ma'am. When they had cooked and eaten, the guru realized that this was a kingdom of fools and wouldn't be a good idea for them to stay there. This is no place for us. Let's go, he says to his disciple. But the disciple didn't want to leave the place. Everything was cheap here. All he wanted was good, cheap food. The guru said, they are all fools. They won't last very long, and you can't tell what they'll do to you next.
Read further.
But the disciple wouldn't listen to the guru's wisdom. He wanted to stay. The guru finally gave up and said, do what you want, I'm going, and left. The disciple stayed on, ate his fill every day, bananas and ghee and rice and wheat, and grew fat like street side sacred bull. One bright day, a thief broke into a rich merchant's house. He had made a hole in the wall and sneaked in as he was carrying out his loot. The wall of the old house and killed him on the spot. His brother ran to the king and complained, Your Highness, when my brother was pursuing his ancient trade, a wall fell on him and killed him. The merchant is to blame. He should have built a good strong wall. You must punish the wrongdoer and compensate the family for the injustice.
Okay. Now what happened? Listen carefully. Those who are not interested, they can sit at home. Offline students, you are not interested, I guess. Now see, guru and disciple both went to the market. So when they came to know that everything was having a same price, okay, so they came to know that this is a kingdom of fool. So they wanted to take advantage of this thing. Suppose you go to market and everything is sold in rupees 10. What will you do? You will start accumulating, whether it is gold, whether it is watch, whether it is grocery. Everything is having 10 rupees. So what will you do? Definitely you will purchase, expensive things at the lowest price. So when they came to know both strangers, so they purchased so many things, okay, for 1 rupee. After that, they cooked food, they eaten their food, and then Guru realized that basically this is a kingdom of fools and it would not be a good idea for them to stay there. Okay, so they thought that they should not live in that place, because the if king is fool, minister is fool, how can they run a good place? So they should move from there. They took that decision. Okay. But when Guru said to his disciple that Guru wanted to go, but his pupil, he wanted to stay there. Okay. He thought that everything what was available there, everything was available at a very low price, at a very cheap rate. Okay. So this is a cheap food. So Guru said that they all are fools and these fools will not last for long. Okay, so you can't say anything that what they will do next, because if they are doing such kind of foolishness, if they are doing such kind of foolish activity now, so what will they be doing tomorrow? What will be they doing in future?